Okay, I'm back. Let's get right into it. So this right here is a video that I'm posting of me doing a rant through this video game called For Honor, which I really like, only because I ain't posting nothing in a minute. Now, I'm trying to be a YouTuber, but I'm not trying that hard. I'm not really posting anything. I'm still working on my cartoon, The Mighty Montreal, but that right there just takes a long time. Animation's a long process, so like it might come out next year. I'm planning for it to come out next year, but for the most part, like, y'all just gonna have to wait. Y'all might just see me post some trailers, y'all might just see me post little animations that has nothing to do with the cartoon, or maybe it will, but for the most part, it's just gonna be delayed until next year, and hopefully to those that, like, watch cartoons or that work in cartoons, work with cartoons, like, understand, like, how serious this stuff is. And, like, I just ain't trying to, like, make a bad impression from my first cartoon. So, that's one. All right, for two, my YouTube channel, Tribal Bay. I ain't been messing with that in a minute. I've just been watching other people's videos. And, like, I don't mean no shade. It's just that, like, I would like to make my own stuff. You feel me? Like, I would like to take this stuff seriously. And, like, actually have some, content. So here are some future content that I will have for y'all. Gaming, which is what you're watching right now. The game is called For Honor. It's actually just a game about strategy and fighting. It's just like a regular fighting game, you feel me? Right now I'm playing Breach, which is online. So like I'm playing against this guy right here who's beating my ass right now. I'm beating his ass. Yeah, I'm beating his ass. And you just like try to take as many points as you can. Like as you can see, there's point A and point B, which is what we have. And we're just trying to like win the game. So yeah, it's a good game. I recommend buying it. So that's gaming, cartoons, The Mighty Montreal, and Stickman on Crack 2007. Now, The Mighty Montreal, that right there, the cartoon I've been working on for a long time. It wasn't really supposed to be serious. It was mostly supposed to be a cartoon that I just made just for the sake of making a cartoon. But, like, I started posting on Instagram, and other people was talking about they can't wait to see it. And, like, you know, I got family members and other people, like, randoms talking about, oh, can I be a part of your cartoon? Can I be a character? Can I be the voice? And it's like, I don't even got a script yet. You feel me? So it's like, I'm, like, really... really unorganized with this cartoon, just to keep it 100 with y'all. And I'ma be serious. I really am serious now that I know how serious this is, cause this ain't like no cartoon that like I'm doing for fun. It's actually a cartoon for entertainment. So I would like to entertain y'all and keep y'all entertained and interested for more episodes that's gonna come. And yeah, like that was originally supposed to be a cartoon that I made for fun. But, you know, a whole lot of people just got interested, and now I guess I'm an animator. And, Stickman on Crack 2007, that right there, like, I remember the old YouTube video, Stickman on Crack, and it was like Robot Chicken, except it was stick figures. Like, I remember a Stickman being rolled over by a giant ball. I remember a Stickman being crushed by a giant hamburger. I remember, like, just Stickman on Crack. If you type that in on YouTube, you're gonna see some videos, you feel me? But I'm bringing it back with my animation, Stickman on Crack, because I just like Robot Chicken. I like the second long jokes. I like the little stuff like that. I like the glitches, you know, so I'm gonna do something like that. Stickman on Crack, I'm bringing it back. Feel me? Be on the lookout for that. Now that right there, I might just do as a joke. And but like I'm still have like some of my animation talent. I'm still gonna take it as serious as my original cartoon, The Mighty Montreal. But for the most part, it's just gonna be a cartoon for fun, and it's just gonna be about stick figures, and they're possibly on crack. Okay then. Skits. Yes, I actually have a green screen, so I'm hoping to do some skits with me like talking to myself. And this one skit idea I have is called Schizophrenic. And it's about me talking to myself and going on misadventures and just asking dumbass questions that I have to myself. Like, if you go back to my YouTube channel and, like, just scroll down, and you're gonna see a video of, like, two of me, you feel me? And we're both talking to each other, just saying what's up and nodding ahead, you feel me? So, that right there is like one idea for a skit. It actually sounds like a little show or something like that, you know. But yeah, Schizophrenic, make sure y'all check that out whenever I release it. Cooking, I don't really know how to cook. I know how to cook some things, but my sister knows how to cook, my mom knows how to cook, and my brother knows how to cook. He be making these sandwiches with like croissant bread and ham, and he be putting like cinnamon waffles in it. Like, it looked like something at the Boondocks. Y'all remember the Itis, the Luther Burger? It was something like that. I had to ask for another one. But yeah, you know, cooking, just so we could bring that stuff back. And rants, which is what I'm doing right now. I'm just ranting about, you know, future ideas and things that I'm going to do on my YouTube. You feel me? So be on the lookout. And then, like, you know, I might get some life advice, you know, life that I didn't live, or life that I did live, or life that I think about, and it's like, oh, what would I do if I was in that certain situation? So, you know, just rants about things that, you know, that might need to be heard, that might need to be said. Who knows? And music is another thing. It's gonna be music from my cartoon, music from yours truly, music from my sister Yolani from Soul. Make sure y'all follow her on Instagram, or follow her photography page, Faceless Photography. And, you know, shout out to her, support her, you feel me? Because she's actually serious with her craft. Me, I just like messing around with my talent. So make sure y'all check her out, make sure y'all follow her music. And I'm also going to be like promoting music of other people, you know, up and coming artists or people who are already big and I just happen to like their songs. But for the most part, I want to focus on up and coming artists, because there's so many talented people in this world who ain't as big as those who ain't got no talent, you feel me? So I'm just trying to like let it be known that, like, oh, those who got talent, those who was meant to be in this industry, just know that like you got some ears, you feel me? And last but not least, my father, my dad, I would like to take this moment to say Happy Father's Day to my dad. As far as I can remember, he was a cool guy, you know? Like, he was a cool guy, you know? Like I was a baby, really. I was a baby when we separated. And, like, I remember crying myself to sleep every night. And then, like, one day I just stopped crying. But, like, I really love my dad. And, like, I hope he knows that, like, I love him. Because, like, while he was alive, I wouldn't really, like, give him no attention like that. I wouldn't really, like, I wouldn't call him. I wouldn't do nothing. You feel me? And, like, I would call him, but it was, like, I had all the time in the world to try to, like, reconnect with him, and I didn't do nothing with it, and I just feel like shit for it. And it's not like nothing that's gonna make me feel better. I know I ain't gonna feel better off of this, but at least I know that I love my dad, and he knows that I love him. You know, send it out to the universe. I love my dad. And it really sucks, like, when you lose a dad, like, especially, like, when you ain't, like, really known much about him, or, like, when you wanted to know so much about him, but you really didn't know, like, how to, and, like, now it's, like, you don't, like, really know what, you don't really, like, know what to do with yourself. You don't know half the things that you wanted to know, that your dad could have taught you about yourself. You feel me? You don't know nothing about being a man, none of that, you feel me? So it's like, you know, it sucks, but at least he's chilling, you feel me? He's not hurting like the rest of us. He's not on this godforsaken planet, you feel me? He's not, it's all good, you feel me? It's all good. And I just wanted to take this time to tell y'all to appreciate y'all fathers, appreciate those that's in your love life, you feel me? And don't let no form of hatred come between you and what you love, or who you love, you feel me? Because life is, like, way too damn short, and, like, don't nobody really get it until it's too late, you feel me? Like, I really thought I had all the time in the world to try to get rid of whatever fucking issue I had, and, like, I really thought that shit, and really I didn't, And now I just gotta like deal with the fact that like I'm by myself. You feel me? I'm like by myself in this manhood. You feel me? So like just take time to appreciate your dad. You feel me? And to all the moms out there, don't be bitter. Don't be bitter. All right, let your kids see your dad. I don't care how he was towards you. At least let your kids see him and let them decide on whether they want to be with him or not. Because, not to put no blame on my moms, but we just moved like everywhere, and it was like I couldn't really like see my dad like that. You feel me? Like, he would come through when I lived in Los Angeles, but I was just a kid and I was just playing outside and all that junk. And then we moved to Vegas and I hardly got to know anybody in Los Angeles. And then I just lost connection. And it was not to put no blame on my mom, because most of the blame was myself. I could have been fuck this shit, I want to see my dad, but for some reason I didn't take advantage, you feel me? And it's I feel like shit because of that. And I ain't never gonna feel good, honestly. But I accept it. And I just wanna say that for the moms out there, don't be bitter with your damn kids, and don't be using your fucking kids against your motherfucking baby daddy, because that shit ain't right. That shit ain't right. We gotta break this fucking cycle. I mean, not just black people, but every fucking body. You feel me? Kids deserve to see they fucking dads. You feel me? Dads deserve to see their kids. Don't act like that. That goes to any fucking woman who thinks that she can use her kid against her motherfucking. That's out of pocket. Fuck you. And but yeah, back to my dad. He was just a cool nigga, as far as I remember. You feel me? He was chill. He was always laughing, always cracking jokes. He always had some slick shit to say. He was just that nigga, you feel me? He was the person that I got it from, you feel me? So when y'all hear me talk with confidence in my voice, don't fucking call me no pimp, don't call me no player, don't call me none of that shit. Nigga, I sound just like my dad. I ain't pretending to be nothing but who I am. You feel me? So I get all that shit. I get my style from my dad. I get the way I talk from my dad. I ain't no motherfucking knucklehead like all these other niggas. You feel me? I'm fucking blessed. Shout out to my dad. You feel me? But yeah, Dad, I just wanted to send out to the universe that I love you, and Happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. And that's about it. So yeah, y'all, just be on the lookout for new content coming to the channel. Be on the lookout for the cartoon that's gonna come next year with full episodes, you feel me? And be on the lookout for anything else that's left to come. And I got 2 more minutes at this shit. Well, really, I ain't got nothing to say. You feel me? I only had 3 things written. Father's Day, the YouTube channel, and my cartoon is going to be delayed. But I'm also going to take this time to say that I quit my job. I quit my job. I was tired of that bitch. And you can call me lazy if you want. You can say, Trav, this YouTube thing ain't going to work, da-da-da-da-da. But y'all really don't. Kind of believe, but only if I'm serious at it, you feel me? Which is what I'm trying to be, you feel me? But if I'm posting up in video. So yes, I'm trying to be a YouTuber, but I'm trying to use my creative talents to set me free from all this fucking heartache and pain and just all this shit. All this shit from having to get up and go to work and worry about a paycheck to just fucking waking up and having nothing to do when I get out of bed. So YouTube is just something that's gonna save my life, you feel me? So watch my YouTube channel, get entertained, get inspired, get some inspiration, you feel me? And do what the fuck it is you wanna do. Cause like I said, I quit my job for the sake of maximizing my talents, you feel me? I like maximizing my creativity, my nigga. Shout out to Red Man. And I'm just gonna go because I got 15 minutes of this shit. But make sure y'all support the channel and don't subscribe because I really don't care. All right, peace out.